Now let's have a look at the pen tool. As in Illustrator, with the pen tool you can create curved paths. I outlined a letter D, and made a screenshot of its nodes and handles. I will recreate the letter D with the pen tool. As we can see, the nodes of the large curves are placed at the outer edges of the curve. And their handles are perfectly horizontal or vertical. To place the first point, I click and hold down the mouse. I now see a handle, or arm, that I can move around. When I press Ctrl, I can place the arm perfectly vertical. I will place the arm at the same height as in the example. Now I let go of the mouse and Ctrl. Then I click on the second point, which is the highest point of the curve. I hold down the mouse down again, and press Ctrl. Now I drag the handle perfectly horizontal. I will make the length of the left arm fit the left example. The right arm needs to be shorter, but I will do that at a later point. I click on the third point, and drag. I don't have to press Ctrl, because the arm doesn't have to be horizontal. I will match the left arm. Now I will go up. Because I also have a right arm, I have a curve, and not a straight line. To get a straight line, I need to remove the right arm. To remove the right arm, I press Shift plus L. I see I now have a straight line. Because I need the line to go up vertically, I press Ctrl. I click on the point above, and still hold down Ctrl, to also get a vertical arm. I click on the next point, hold Ctrl, and drag to match the right arm. I have a sharp corner again, so I press Shift plus L. Now we have a new situation. I can't drag on the node above, because that would give me a curve below. So I hold Ctrl, and click on the next point. Now I press Enter. To continue, I click on the last point, and hold down the mouse. I drag out a single arm. I click on the next point, drag, and match the left arm. To get a sharp corner, I press Shift L again. I hold Ctrl, click on the next point, still hold Ctrl, and drag out a vertical arm. I click, press Enter, and drag out the left arm. I press Shift L and click. I hold Ctrl, and click on the point below. At the corner, I only need a left arm. So I press Enter, and then drag the left arm. I click and drag, and press Shift L. I hold Ctrl, and click on the point above. Then I click on the next point, which also gives a straight line. I press Enter, and drag an arm out. Then I click, and hold Ctrl, and match the left arm. This is the second point where I will adjust the right arm later. To finish the path, I click on the first point again, hold Ctrl, and match the bottom arm. Now I click on the node tool. I will adjust the two right arms, that are too long. I click on the node on top, and hold my mouse above the right arm. I hold Ctrl, and drag the arm to match. I do the same for the bottom node. I click on it, hold Ctrl, and drag the right arm in. The outer path is now finished. Now I draw the inner path. I click on the pen tool. I click, hold Ctrl, and drag. Then I click, hold Ctrl, and drag again. As before, I will adjust the right arm later. I click and drag. To get a corner, I press Shift L again. I hold Ctrl, and click. I press Enter, and drag an arm. Then I click, hold Ctrl, and drag. And to finish, I click, hold Ctrl, and drag. Like before, I adjust the top and bottom arms. I click on the node on top, and hold my mouse above the right arm. I hold Ctrl, and drag the arm to match. I do the same for the bottom node. I click on it, hold Ctrl, and drag the right arm in. The inner path is now finished. Now I have to make the paths a compound path. I select them both, and go to Path, Difference. I will make the trace letter black. In the next lecture, we will have a closer look at the node tool.